everybody. So this is my February favorites. It's a short month, but I do have quite a few favorites. I'm also going to have quite a few favorites in my family favorites on my second channel, which has more of the random non-beauty things. Put all my favorites into my Sephora bag. Everything's pretty small. First thing, my PMD system. This is a lifesaver to me. I've mentioned this recently, and I recently got the pro version. I've been using the regular PMD Plus for about 3 years now, and just to get an upgrade from that to like the pro, which is nice and sleek. There's extra settings on this one instead of just one on and off setting. There's a low and a high setting on this. And it comes with extra brush heads, and I have used my PMD Plus so much on my face. What it is a microdermabrasion system, and you kind of just glide it across your face, and it takes off the top layer of your skin, which makes your body create new skin cells. Great for me. It makes the texture of my skin super smooth, helps deal with my acne scars. I used to have really, really, really dark acne scars, and they all definitely have lightened up a lot. The reason it's in my favorites, aside from it doing miracles for my skin over the past few years, is that now I'm using it on my legs because I have really bruised legs from scratching. It bruises really easily from like bug bites and just generally when I scratch. Hopefully over time PMD will work its magic and everything will be good again, because I'm also going to use like, you know, lightening serums I would use on my face onto my spots on my legs as well. Check out the link below for more information on that. Now let's talk brushes. This past month, and basically ending half of January, I've been using these brushes from Amazon. I've been using the Beauty Junkies face brushes a lot in my foundation reviews. I love their face brushes. They're synthetic ones. They look a lot like Sigma's Sigmax brushes, but they're like affordable dupes of them. And to be honest, I kind of like them better. And a lot of you who have tried them told me that you like them better too. They're so affordable. With my coupon code, which is Sandwich without the E, you can get basically any of their brushes for about $5 to $6 each. That is cheap, and Sigma's brushes are over $10. I own some, and I can definitely tell you they are comparable. Beauty Junkie, which is exclusively sold on Amazon, recently came out with an 8-piece eye brush set, and I've been testing it out for the past few weeks. I must say, they are worth the money. You can get each of these brushes individually for $5 to $6, or you can buy the entire brush set that comes with this entire pouch for $26 with my code. Usually it retails about $35. If you buy it, you know, as a set with my code, each brush comes out to like $3. That is affordable. So what it comes with is a pro blending brush, which I use a lot. It's the typical blending brush for any eyeshadows I would use in my crease or just anywhere. I love brushes like this. Then they have a fluffier blending brush, which is more of a longer dome shape, which I use without any shadow, and I blend out any harsh lines. The angled shading, which I use all the time now. I used it today for my brow bone highlight. It's nice and dense and fluffy. Then there's the pro crease, which is a lot like the pro blending. It says it's tapered, but it's not super tapered. It's just shorter in my opinion. It's not as long, if you guys can see that. There's also an all over shader brush, which is nice and dense. I use this for my lid color in my Jaclyn Hill favorites video review and tutorial. If you haven't seen it, I will link it off around here. I used a lot of these brushes there. Then there is also a pencil brush. It's nice and tapered and it's small. So if you have smaller eyes, I would recommend this one. It's very, very skinny. The last two brushes are eyeliner brushes. One being the flat definer, which you can use for eyeliner, but I don't like to use flat brushes. I like to use angled brushes. So I prefer the angled eyeliner brush. It's nice and thin and could make a nice precise thin line with gel liner, so I highly recommend this one. And then the flat one I like to use for concealing underneath my brows or going around my nails with acetone. It's a really nice brush for that. That's why I used it for today, because I just painted my nails. And it just helps me clean up the lines because it's nice and dense and stable. All in all, for the price, it's a nice, well-rounded kit, and I don't have a problem with any of the brushes shedding or bleeding. My highlight, ugh. My highlight love. If you've watched my LA haul, you already know what I'm talking about. This is the Kevin Aucoin Candlelight Highlighter, and this thing is so beautiful, as Whaley would say. So beautiful. It's beautiful. I mean, I'm not a super experienced person when it comes to Kevin Aucoin products, but the highlighter is just, it's amazing. I was addicted to my Hourglass one, and this one just changed my life. I'm not wearing it right now. I wore it in a lot of my videos, which I can link off, but I didn't wear it right now because I'm in a foundation review. If you have a chance to check this out, I highly recommend it. It's beautiful. It's not too shimmery, it's not too glittery, but it's just that perfect, not too gold, not too pink, just nice glow. It's on the yellow tone side, I will say that. It's like a champagne color, but a champagne color that I think would work on a bunch of skin tones. I've been using this LA Girl Pro Conceal HD Concealer as my under eye concealer this past month, and this is shade Creamy Beige. It's kind of on like a light peachy neutral side. It's not yellow, but it's great for the under eye, and it's so affordable. I picked these up at IMATS from Lady Moss's booth, but you can check them out on her website from Lady Moss Beauty. She has a lot of the LA Girl products, and this is a very, very popular concealer. I've seen it all over Instagram, and I also have a few of the darker shades for contouring. It's just a really good affordable concealer that has a lot of coverage, and it has a lip gloss applicator, so I just usually paint it on underneath my eyes and then take a beauty blender to blend it out. So if you've been wondering what's been under my eyes on a lot of videos this month, it's this concealer for sure. I set that concealer with the new Besame Brightening Vanilla Translucent Powder. This recently hit Sephora. It's kind of like a Ben Nye Banana Powder, not dupe, it's more like the high-end version of it. It comes with this little puff. It costs more, so I would say it's not an affordable dupe, obviously. It comes with a powder puff and it has a cover to it, so it doesn't just leak out, and it has a little sifter hole so you can close it instead, and it makes it travel friendly, which I like. But I don't really like the sifters because I don't use it with a puff. It's pretty hard to get the product to come out, like even if you shake it upside down, a lot of it doesn't show up on the puff. And I like to use a lot to set my under eye concealer. I don't like it to crease and I don't like it to move. So you can easily just take the sifter out. I accidentally did that when I first opened the product, and just be really, really careful with your brush and just seal it back afterwards. Otherwise, I mean, that's smart that they gave that option so people like me can open it and yet still have it good to travel when I seal it back up. Looks flawless, doesn't sink into any of my fine lines or pores, and it doesn't give that ghostly, you know, cast when you take flash photography pictures. Last makeup product for this video is the eyeliner I've been wearing a lot this month, and this is the Inglot number 77 gel liner. It's just the matte black. It is my favorite gel liner, and it has been for a long time. I recently picked up another one before I went to LA, because the only thing about this is that it dries out decently fast. My last one dried out. I didn't realize like there were products out there that you can, you know, mix. Oh, I realized it, but I didn't own any, that you can mix into your gel liner and, you know, bring it back to life. So now that I have that, I use the Makeup Forever. I think it's called Aqua Seal or Aqua something. It comes in a little bottle, and I'm just gonna keep this thing alive for as long as possible. But I just opened a new one, and you know that satisfying feeling when you use a new product for the first time. Love, 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 love the matte black line. It's so pigmented and it lasts a long time, like as far as not going up my lid or anything like that. Love it, love it, love it. And it's pretty affordable. I will link it off down below. You can get it on Amazon. I have one hair favorite for the month. If you haven't noticed, I have a, if I turn this way you can see, the crap ton of baby hairs growing up. I've always had a lot of baby hairs naturally, especially in this corner. A lot of people think I shaved this section of my hair, which I never did. I just have a lot of baby hairs naturally. And I had a lot of breakage in October when I told you guys I had to dye my roots darker because my roots just couldn't stay light from frequent bleaching when I had the platinum silver hair. Like, it was so, like, super light all over, roots and all. So that caused the breakage in October. I told you guys that before I darkened my roots. So now that all the breakage has grown out, it is starting to do this. Luckily, I can smooth it down, but I have a lot of like random areas with that right now. I'm not balding, but I had breakage. So what I've been using is this product that my stylist has at his salon. It's the Brazilian Blowout Acai Brazilian Dry Oil. And I know it's confusing because it's dry oil, but that's exactly what it is. I've mentioned it before in my hair care routine when I had silver hair. If you haven't seen that, there it is. It is an oil, obviously, but then when you apply it on, it doesn't make your hair greasy. It gives that dry, textury feeling, so it doesn't weigh it down. But I can't fluff it up too much because of my baby hair situation. But I've been liking it for my baby hairs, and I was wondering, for all those out there who have baby hairs, what do you use to deal with it? Because this is fine for me right now, but of course I always want to hear about other products. So let me know down below if you have any recommendations for that, because I'm going to be dealing with these bad boys for a little while. Last thing is this juice. I love it. It's from Blueprint. I got it at Whole Foods, and it is the lemon cayenne agave. I've been making my own lemon cayenne agave juice at home because it's just more affordable. But when I'm like on the go and I'm passing a Whole Foods, I just grab one. It's about like $7 or $8. It's really, really good. It's not too much cayenne. A lot of brands that have this mixture put way too much cayenne and it will burn. But this one's very easily drunken. It doesn't burn too much. This is 100% raw and organic and cold pressed, and it comes with 16 ounces. So if you're passing by Whole Foods and you just happen to see this, I recommend it. I also like their cashew milk, but it's been sold out a lot lately. But at one point I was drinking like 2 or 3 of these a day, and that was crazy. And I'm not being sponsored to say this. I don't even know Blueprint like that. But they have some good lemon cayenne agave. those are my February favorites. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in a later video. Oh, also, P.S. Who's going to BeautyCon Texas? I am pretty sure I will be there. It'll be my first time going to Texas, so if you have any places to recommend around Dallas, because in Dallas, places to shop, to eat, or whatever the heck, let me know down below or contact me on some social media. I would love to hear if you're going and places you recommend. So yeah, I'll see you guys later. Bye. My wireless Bluetooth headphones, they have a little mic right here, and a lot of people have been asking me about them because I wear them a lot in my vlogs. They are super light, they're kind of noise canceling as well.